We are here today with Ambassador Romana Vlahutin. She is the Ambassador at Large for Connectivity at European External Action Service. Thank you so much for being with us today.
It's a real pleasure.
Connectivity, you know, now is a buzzword in international relations. Everybody talks about connectivity. No one better than you to try to explain to us what is connectivity.
I think the best way to explain, you said it's a buzzword, but connectivity is something that we have been doing forever. And when you look at the EU, European Union itself is a result of connectivity. I think it best describes actually what we are trying to do here. So we are trying to find a way of coping with the challenges of new technologies, and here I particularly think of the digital technology and the way changing our world. The fact that world is becoming a smaller place, that geography doesn't matter that much anymore, but that we became much more interconnected in general, that these global supply chains are something that we all depend on. So we are trying to really understand the scope of the challenge and try to figure out what are our best answers for it, using, I think, probably the world's best knowledge on how to connect, because this is, as I said, what European Union has been doing for decades.
Yeah, as you mentioned, I mean, it's in the connectivity, is in the ADN, right?
DNA of the EU.
So how can we compare our model of connectivity with others? Because as you know, there's a lot of controversy on how different powers are promoting connectivity abroad. So
I think for us, connectivity has two basic principles. I mean, for connectivity to really benefit the societies, it has two basic principles. One is sustainability. Mm-hmm. So whatever you invest in connectivity needs to bring benefits: economic, financial, social, environmental. And this is key. It's not something where you build without thinking what are the consequences of building a certain piece of infrastructure. So sustainability for us is an underlying principle. The second one is level playing field. We think whoever competes, and primarily here I think of businesses and private capital, competes in all kind of infrastructure developments, there has to be, or business, there has to be a situation where everyone starts from the same sort of point, and everyone is equal in terms of rights and obligations. So I think it's very important to promote healthy competition, and competition that in the end will produce quality. There is a lot of discussion. Our Japanese colleagues, for example, we call it EU connectivity and the principles of sustainability. Our Japanese colleagues call it quality infrastructure. But the philosophy of it is all the same. So when we invest into such capital infrastructure pieces, be it physical infrastructure, be it infrastructure for digital connectivity, it really has to be able to survive the test of time.
I think the people in the EU, I mean, we know quite well, you know, for the reasons you mentioned before, how beneficial it is to promote connectivity inside the EU. But what can you tell also for EU Europeans, you know, how can we benefit from promoting connectivity, I mean, beyond our borders?
I mean, we can benefit in very many ways. One thing that is for sure, I mean, connectivity is precondition for growth. And it's absolutely in the interest of the EU that countries that we invest in do grow, that they develop at a pace and in a way which is beneficial for them, that we create more competitiveness all over globally, and that this competitiveness in the end make these countries more resilient. It is really in our interest, because if you wish, in a very plain words, if you want to be economically active, of course that you want to be active in a market that is predictable, that is stable, where there's rule of law, and where you can really go as an investor and feel that your investment makes sense. So I think by promoting connectivity, you by definition promote the interests of European Union, be them political, be economic, be security.
And taking all of this into account, taking into account the relevance of this issue, what can we expect of the next EU Commission? I mean,
I think it's already very well known that, you know, the key sort of ambition of the incoming Commission is geopolitical Europe. And in a way, geopolitical Europe is connectivity is all about that. It's how we project ourselves and our capacity in terms of regulatory frameworks, in terms of capital investment in infrastructure, and in terms of our ability to create sort of political partnerships and alliances on growth that is sustainable and that is beneficial. So it is, in a way, if you wish, an ideal filter or an ideal policy framework through which we can prove or we can promote geopolitical Europe in very concrete terms.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thanks a lot. Good.